What's up? What's up? What's up, people?
Uptown is here. Ratchet Poppy, that's what they call me. Sometimes they call me Mr. Receipt. Sometimes they call me El Capitan. You know. I'm here. I'm in the building. Welcome to another episode of Uptown Radio. Tonight, we are going to celebrate the late, great Andre Harrell. He is one of the founders of a record label called Uptown Records. You know what I'm saying? Definitely the family tree in which the roots are connected to Andre Harrell are definitely great. You know what I'm saying? Without Andre, there is definitely a lot of people that we would not have here. There would be no Diddy, there would be no Mary J. Blige, no Heavy D, no Lost Boys. If there was no Puff, there would be no Big. You know what I'm saying? So the list goes on. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, the roots that come from the tree of Andre Harrell, you know, are definitely roots that are legendary and should be respected. And we are going to pay tribute to the late, great Andre Harrell, the founder of Uptown Records. This is Uptown Radio. No coincidence, by the way, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I didn't name Uptown Radio after Andre Harrell, but definitely, you know, he's had a career that is, like very few other people, you know what I'm saying? He was definitely a unique character and a unique guy. And, like I said, I think that it is only right that we pay tribute, you know what I'm saying, to Andre Harrell. You know, right now, tonight, I got on, you can't really see it, I got on a Mary J. Blige t-shirt, you know what I'm saying? Once again, you know, like I said, just paying homage, because Andre, you know, I don't know if people ever saw the Mary doc, but Andre actually drove up to Yonkers himself personally, you know what I'm saying, to hear Mary sing, because, you know, that's just the kind of dude that he was. So I'm gonna take a couple minutes, wait to see who's gonna log on and join me, and then we're gonna log on and join me, and then we're gonna jump right into this list. I know y'all saw by now the dude with the, you know, now he has like a chicken wing, who decided to jump on stage and attempt to look like he was trying to, for those of you who watch wrestling, look like he was trying to like spear him or like football tackle, you know what I'm saying, Chappelle. Which was crazy to me because I'm sitting there like, if you look at Chappelle's career, right? He has a podcast with Mos Def, aka Yasiin Bey, and Talib Kweli. Shout out to them, shout out to Black Star. They got a new project coming out that will be available. I think you can only get it if you subscribe to their podcast, which is pretty dope. You know what I'm saying? That makes it kind of exclusive. Anyway, so Chappelle hangs out with Mos Def, Talib Kweli, Busta Rhymes. Hangs out with a lot of niggas from Brooklyn. Like, why would you think that you're going to be able to run on stage and do something to this man? Right? Like, nah, like, clearly, that's not what you want. That wasn't cool, you know what I'm saying? I think at the end of the day, Chappelle, as a creator, as a comedian, he has the right to do his material and not have to have anyone come and disrupt his show with violence. Comedians are used to hecklers. Hecklers is one thing, right? To an extent. But I think when, you know, he's doing his job and someone comes to disrupt him, you know, it's not cool. I mean, you know, when people doing their job, when, you know, that dude is at Arby's, nobody's telling him to, you know what I'm saying, hurry up with them goddamn curly fries. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I think everybody deserves the right to do their job. I mean, he has the right to say what he wants to say. You know, we do have this thing called free speech. And I think that the people who are listening also have the right to be offended. right? But it's one thing to be offended. There's another thing to want to commit an act of violence just because you don't like something that someone says. That's a slippery slope. I think that's just not cool. Like I said, to commit an act of violence just because you didn't like something that someone said. It's giving them way too much power and control over you and your emotions. I was kind of happy that Chris Rock was able to run on stage and get a little quick joke off. I thought that was cool. You know, I'm sure some people didn't like it, but Chris been real quiet. So for him to, you know, seize that opportunity to just get a little quick jab in, I'm for it. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, we are going to get into this Andre Harrell playlist. Like I said, the tree that Andre Harrell planted when he started Uptown Records consists of a lot of guys. There's Jodeci, there's Father MC, there's Mary J. Blige, there's Diddy, Heavy D. So, you know what I'm saying? We're going, you know, it's going to be like a little trip back in time. It's a little trip back to the 90s. So, let's go. She moving, baby, yeah. So that is Father MC featuring Jodeci. Like I said, you know, Andre Harrell planted some roots in hip hop and R&B that definitely molded and shaped the culture. He was one of the gatekeepers and the tastemakers. I mean, you know, he was known for being very pristine, always popping champagne and buble, as he would like to refer to it as. And I mean, I think a lot of times, you know, people definitely don't get their flowers while they're here. And there are a lot of people like Andre Harrell who don't necessarily get the credit that they deserve for making our culture what it is, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm going to attempt to do tonight. I'm gonna attempt to shine some light on his career, some of the contributions that he gave to us, and you know, let y'all hear some dope music, you know what I'm saying? Let's go. Oh,
find myself to keep me high. But destination leads me to a dead end. Over and over and over again. They told me to wait, so I waited, anticipated, debated, and delayed it. But still came up with the same old thing. Nothing. It seems as if every time I find the right girl, she turns out to be the very wrong girl. Tell me, y'all, when will this madness stop? I want somebody to love me for me, not because I'm MC heavy D. I'm looking for a love that's as solid as a rock.
Another one of the drinks you gave us. Everybody remember this? I'll be sure. You know what I'm saying?
Under, please don't you leave.
MJB. The godfather of what we know as modern R&B.
Watch the sunrise, or listen to JoJo Casey sing us a verse.
But definitely does not get the credit he deserves. I'll be sure. God and Jodeci all up under one roof. A lot of time. Too many people sleep on it. And you add Mary J. Blige to that. You know what I'm saying? Who else? Jeff Wright, you know what I'm saying? Let's go.
No question, big kids in full effect.
Yeah, I'ma kick the Willie Bobo. Check it, yo. No question. Ew, what's the
411,
hon? What's the
411?
I got it going on, hon.
I got it going on, hon.
What's the 411, hon?
What's the 411?
I got it going on.
Ew, I got it going on.
Will I be pooping on this chair? The nigga from last year. Jabo's hanging back. He Tommy Hilfiger top gear. Take no shorts. I'm doing lovely in all sports. Even swing the pole at the hole on my golf course. Some say I'm fancy because I'm horny and nasty. If I see some rugged joint, then I won't let it pass me. I take no shorts. Let suckers step up and see. I'll flip the script and get harder than Jeopardy. I shot the sheriff and the motherfucking deputy. Test me. Check it. I'm not Keith Sweat, but bet that ass that I can make it last. Skins turn their head so fast, they end up catching whiplash. If Hun's a monster, I'm Kyle Lewis on the meter dash. It's Grand Poober, baby, and I'm getting crazy cash. What's the 411? Let me know, Hun. What's the 411?
Forgot about this one.
Jack Knight in Dakota House. All we wanna do is make
Monifah
it bounce.
Monifah, part of that Uptown family.
Monifah, could you turn me out? Show me what your thing is all about. Jack Knight in Dakota House. All we wanna do is make it bounce. Monifah, could you turn me out? Show me what your thing is all about.
Uptown family's extensive. Telling you, the godfather of what we know now as play is modern R&B. Andre Harrell, for sure. Definitely.
Could you just put that thing on me?
Y'all remember this. So for real, let's go. Rest in peace, Andre Harrell, the godfather of modern R&B. I said it. If you ain't hear nobody else say it, I said it. Going back and forth, back and forth, baby.
I stay soaking, pouring colognes. I keep dick Coogee sweaters handy,
cause that's that
shit. I stay laced because my body got Versace taste. Rolex on my cuff, flooded with diamonds and stuff. I half a dozen hundred Benz coupe in my driveway. Tried to have it my way, the flyway led to a bad day. I should have kept it real when I was with you. Instead, I dissed you, so now I miss you.
True. Different back in the days, you know, they used innuendos, taste your love. Basically, he's not saying, ladies, he's saying he's not afraid to eat the pussy. You know what I'm saying? He's not afraid to eat it, to munch the carpet, to take the, to make the Australian kiss. You know what I'm saying? If you don't get that, it's because the kiss is down under. You know what I'm saying? He's not afraid to go downtown and hang out with SWV. Either way, he's not afraid. You gotta give him a man his props for not being afraid, you know what I'm saying? You know, because it's dangerous out here, you know what I'm saying? For dudes who's not doing it, you know what I'm saying? Speaking of which, I forget, I was listening to Charlamagne today on Power 105, and apparently the woman who got the donkey of the day today, she got the donkey of the day because she tried to shoot a man who didn't want to eat the box. So it's dangerous out here. Fellas, if you're brave like Horace and you're not afraid, do your thing. He said there's nothing he won't try, ladies. That means he's eating a butt too. He's eating ass. You heard him. He's not afraid to taste your love. That means he's eating the box and the butt. He's going to Brown Town. Let's go.
He's on your neck.
Like a gentleman, he said, baby, come over, lay down. But Horace is a goddamn gentleman, gotta respect it. You know what I'm saying? You know, goddamn gentleman, Horace is.
For you.
fucking chill. Alright, it's a little too slow for me. Gotta turn it up a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In this here rap game, for those that claim to be the best, I tear them out the frame. I'm representing putting queens on the map. Devil's rings with some baggy jeans when I rap. Come up with a style that they call verse attack. But treat me like no lame, I've been in this game for a while. I seen a lot to come, I seen a lot to go. I seen a lot to break, I seen a lot to blow. And yo, it's a trip, see a nigga slip. Get up, bro, nigga, nigga, get up, bro, get up. You don't even know the half of my crew. To be talking what you talking and to act like you do. Yo, said it, you fucking cross my line and hit the border. LB fam, start attacking, someone's acting out of order. Put on your leather gloves and hats and get your bits and bats. And get the gats just in case you take it to the stack to the G.
So, we talked about, you know what I'm saying, you know, the tree and the roots that Andre Harrell laid down, you know what I'm saying? And you got to think about, you know, music in the 90s, especially when you were in New York, you know what I'm saying? It was all about relationships and everybody, you know what I'm saying, like, mess with each other, right? So Andre gave us Lost Boys, who also gave us Puff. Puff gave us Big. Big gave us Little Kim and Junior Mafia. So later on, there would have been no Little Kim and Lost Boys if it wasn't for Andre Harrell. You know what I'm saying? Like, all the dots connect. Like, he is the godfather of, you know, not only modern R&B, but I would dare say the New York music scene in the 90s, right? Because I'm sure within 6 degrees of separation, every major artist coming out of New York could probably low-key be connected to Andre in some way. You know what I'm saying? Because, like I said, Andre brought us Puff. We know Puff brought us Big. He brought us The Lox. He brought us Mace. He brought us Total. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, Andre also gave us MJB, Father MC, The Lost Boys, Monifah, Guy. You know what I'm saying? And you think about who was out there working with who, like, it's all connected. You know what I'm saying? But music and life is strange like that. But that's why I said, you know, a brother like Andre Harrell hasn't, at least from what I've seen, he hasn't been given his flowers in the way that he should have gotten them. So tonight, that's what we're doing, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you know, hopefully y'all can enjoy this with me, you know what I'm saying? If not, you know, I understand. Go.
I got nothing but love for you, baby. I got nothing but love for you, honey. I got nothing but love for you, baby. I got nothing but love for you, honey. I got nothing but love for you, baby. I got nothing but love for you, honey. I got nothing but love for you, baby. I got nothing but love for you, honey. I got nothing but love for you, baby. I got nothing but love.
You gonna keep it light skin real quick. Keep it light skin. Out there purposely trying to have babies with light-skinned dudes because they thought their babies were going to get good hair. You know what I'm saying? This time was real. It was horrible. Listen, I'm right in the middle. So, you know, like, I'm not light-skinned. I'm not dark-skinned. I'm right in the middle. So I was always good with. Listen, light-skinned dudes is winning. See you. 88 is a good year for the light skin. Good year for the light skin, brothers. But Andre Harrell gave me my favorite R&B group of all time. Anybody who knows me knows that I am a Jodeci fan. I got a chance to see them recently. It was a dream of mine since I was a little kid. I got a chance to see Jodeci perform recently. It was one of the best times I ever had in my life. Jodeci versus God.
Oh, yeah.
Who is winning? I mean, it's evenly matched because you know all these niggas in these groups gonna be singing anyway. Yeah. Should've been Jodeci versus Glass. They right in the same pocket too. I would have followed up like this. Thank you, Andre, because you gave us all of this greatness. The godfather of modern R&B. I don't know if anybody's ever gave him that title, but I did. He made a mixtape for you. Like he put in work. It's mixtape era.
I can't believe that this is happening to us.
You know, I mean, now a nigga might make a playlist for you. It don't be better than the Uptown Radio playlist though. For sure. Never. Not never. Talk to me nice. Cause even positive tape was talking to the ladies nice.
when you go, you hear the yo bit.
I'm back in my married bag.
Can remember when we had,
Listen, if we're not just happy because Andre gave us married, right? Like, forget the Jodeci. I don't forget that, right? But if you want to forget about the Jodeci, forget about the Heavy D, forget about the Monifah, forget about the Soul For Real, the Horace Brown. Listen, it's, you see, I'm keep naming names because Andre gave us so much, right? But if there is one person in R&B music that you want to be thankful for in connection to the late, great Andre Harrell, be thankful that he took that drive. If anybody saw, like I said, y'all saw the Mary Doc, right? Took the drive up to Yonkers in his Benz, parked on the street. People thought he was gonna get robbed. He ain't care anyway. Went upstairs and listened to this woman, this young girl sing, and decided to sign her to Uptown Records, right? Because between What's the 411 and My Life and Share My World, three of the most classic R&B albums ever made. But definitely My Life. Like, that was for people who are in a certain age bracket, that was the soundtrack to life. Approaching hours, so I'm gonna fly through this My Life album real quick.
Time on my hand, since you've been away, boy, I ain't got no plans. No, 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 no. And the sound against my window pane, it's slowly driving me insane. Boy, I'm going down. I'm going down. Cause you ain't around, baby. My whole world's inside.
And one of the best remix albums ever made. Let's not forget that. The remixes to this album are fire. For the last year, you need to see the Mary J. Blige My Life documentary. It is definitely a great watch. I would definitely recommend having some Kleenex nearby, because as a grown ass man in my 40s, I was tearing up watching it. But, or if you, you just, sometimes I like to watch things more than once because you never know, you watch it again for the second or third time, you see stuff that you missed, give it another watch, for real. You know what I'm saying? It is definitely worth a second or a third watch. I believe it was on Amazon. Check it out. Like I said, I'm just doing this for the culture. I ain't getting no check from Mary J. Blige or Uptown Records. Uptown Records is not affiliated with Uptown Radio. We just love Uptown. We some people from Harlem that just love music. That's what we do over here. Me, the executioner, Mel, this is what we do for the culture. It's one of my faves right here. So I think I might let this one back all the way out. I don't know. Please do not listen to this song. I don't know what it might do to your emotional state. You might cry. You might decide you want to go key a car. You might decide you want to go kick a door. And I don't know. I'm not responsible for anybody's emotional state at the moment. However, if you are currently going through some dysfunction in your relationship, this is not the song to be listening to. But I'm going to continue to play it anyway because it's dope. Falling into is my MJ appreciation because we were supposed to do that and it never happened. Oh. I Well, I've been on for over an hour rocking out to this Uptown Radio / Uptown Records playlist. This has been a celebration of the contributions given to us by the late great Andre Harrell. It's been a year since we've lost him. 2 years since we've lost him. And you know, like I said, if you are a lover of music, especially a lover of 90s R&B, which, you know, I mean, 90s hip hop, 90s R&B, which I consider to be like the golden era of music. There's no way that you could appreciate this golden era of music without shining some light on Andre Harrell. So like I said, I'm gonna run down, you know, just some of the list of the artists that, you know, are up under that Andre Harrell family tree. So we all know that, you know, he brought us Puff, and we know what Puff brought us. But outside of that, he gave us Father MC, Jodeci, Heavy D and the Boys, The Lost Boys, I'll Be Sure, Guy, Mary J. Blige, Christopher Williams, Soul For Real, Monifah, Horace Brown. I might be missing one or two, but the point is that, you know, Andre, you know, gave us a great contribution to music and great contribution to our culture, and did it with style and class and grace. And tonight we wanted to just take some time to play some of the music that, you know, came from Uptown Records and just pay homage and salute to Andre Harrell. Next week we got coming Uptown After Dark. The title of next week's episode is to be determined, but you know, it's always good. Once again, I appreciate everybody for logging on with me tonight. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Have a great rest of your week. Happy hump day as always, because, you know, we do this thing on Wednesdays. And like I said, to quote my brother as always, have a great today and a better tomorrow. Peace. Love y'all.